from make your mind. If they ain't showing no love, I don't let it get to my mind. And I be getting to it with my craft divine, I claim what's mine. And I can't play all of those games, had to protect my time. I know that I'm a foreign son. Understanding your brand as an artist. That's a little small for you guys, but understanding your brand. Now, what does this mean, understanding your brand? Right, now as an artist, you may be thinking, I don't have a business, I don't have a brand. Well, yes and no. One, you are the brand, right? You are the brand, and your music here, right, is your marketing. A little messy there, but you get the point. Your brand is you. Your marketing, your music. All right, now that you know that, moving forward. And what the goal is to do is to bridge, is to tap into this market, right? Because your music is what is the bridge, right? Is the bridge. And the bridge fills the gap. The bridge fills the gap. Fills the gap. Now, what does this mean as an artist? All right, that gives you some clarity to understand. All right, you as an artist, aka the brand, your music is the marketing. Trying to reach and be trying to bridge the gap by accessing the market, aka the music market, the music business. That's the market here, right? This is the market. There is cash or money resources in this market and things of that nature. There's people within and outside this market that you're trying to tap into. Don't mind my little people.
Right.
You're trying to get into this market. So how can you penetrate this market? Because markets are closed and you got to offer value to the market. You gotta give something back to the market, because why would the people outside and already in the market want to come to you, right? Want to look at you and say, whoa, check out this thing coming into the market, right? You see what I'm saying? Your music is what's gonna bridge the gap between the people in the market and you coming into the market. You trying to gain a little bit of what's inside this market from the people that are already in that market, right? Music. And there's a certain in that niche of music, there's also different genres and things of that nature. So when you figure out your genre, all right, for example, myself, hip hop. So there's a certain amount of rappers or hip hop artists that are going to be in that field already, and there's going to be a market that has a level of royalties, streaming, income, and things of that nature, and culture resources that are circulating around that market, around that niche, around hip hop. So it's pop, so it's rock, etc. Right? So you gotta understand, all right, your music, you're this person, far out. You're trying to bridge the gap, and you're doing that through music because you want to penetrate the market, right? But you gotta offer, you gotta give something back to the market so that they see value in you. So how can you give back to the market? The same market that you want to tap into, right? And break into some and tap into some of these leaks, cause penetrations within the market, so you can access some of those resources within that market and bridge the gap from where you are and where you want to be. This is how we help our individuals and elite entrepreneurs working with us via our program and things of that nature. But I'm not here to tell you anything about our program. I'm simply here to tell you what your goal is to do as an artist, as a brand, and it is to bridge the gap, to get you from one point to another. And that's exactly what we're here for. This is exactly what this video is for, right? So you being on the outside and the market being on the inside, how do you tap into this? Offering something of value to the market, giving back to the market. The same market that you want to tap into, giving back to that. So how can you give back to the market? Some different things would be in music, hip hop. How can you give back to the market? Right? That's our objective. How to give back to the market. Right, so once you understand this, you can understand, how do I give back to my market? How do I get back to my market? And there's a couple different things. Education. Inform your market. Educate your market. Teach your market. Give them a form of information that they've never seen before. Or that's very new to them. Offer something that's intriguing to them, that only you can provide based upon the information and the sauce and your way of critiquing it, right? Offer something to your market. Free, not free, informational, something of value. The same people that listen to hip hop, how can you resonate with them emotionally, right? How can you relate to them? How can you relate to your audience? Where do you come from? Where do they come from? Offer a level of relatability of who you are, transparency, right? A story. A background, right? Rapport. Where you're from, who you are, what you've done to get where you are, how you can contribute to the industry that you're in, right? Be mindful of that, guys. How you can contribute to the industry is a very big thing, and how you can show up and offer that, right? And really display that. Your message. How are you going to bridge the gap between you and hip-hop, you and your audience? What is your audience like to listen to? Figure out your ideal audience, right? Ideal listener. Identify your ideal listener. Who listens to you? Who listens to MC 333? Who listens to you, right? Identify your ideal listener and how you reach them, how you speak to them. And every time you create, it'll speak to them. It'll resonate with them. Create your music who it's meant to be for. And watch who it's picked up by. I promise you that. So understanding your ideal listener, offering a level of education and information, an offer in general, right, in terms of value or problem alleviation, on how one can bridge the gap between their creativity and their market. Your story, who you are, where you come from, your background, what your reasoning, your why, your mission, right? I can put beside this, or even with your message, that can resonate with message and story, right? Your mission statement, your reasoning why you're in hip hop and why you make music, and the impact that you want to provide to the people that are listening to your music. Your ideal listener. It's the five things. We're going to stick with five. Five is going to create a seal, and this is what's going to create the emotional resonance within you to actually develop the conviction you need to go get this thing done here. Your ideal listener. So who's your audience? Who listens to you? What type of people, you know, what creative things are you into? What are they into? You know, what are the habits that you do that you know you're that listener, that what you do is going to correspond with that listener, that audience, right? Speak to that audience. If you like to talk, if you represent a certain thing, your brand and your music is going to represent you, right? It's going to be an extension of that. So if for me, you know, like my, you guys know, my message is a big thing on education. It's a big thing on spirituality. You're going to hear that through my message. You're going to hear that through my brand. You're going to see that throughout across the board and things of that nature. You know, we're big on cannabis and CBD and overall health. You're going to see that across the aura of our brand here, right? So you got to understand who you're speaking to. I'm speaking to the ones who want to learn about business education, spirituality, and understanding the self and personal transformation. So I know who I'm speaking to. Seen in the unseen, in the realm of the mind and the spirit, right? So the ones who listen to me are also very big on education and understanding the business aspect and personal transformation. Understanding spirituality from the level of controlling their reality. Because spirituality, without controlling your reality, is simply vanity. And this isn't just entertainment, right? And if you're not going to utilize this information, you don't have to watch this video at all. You know what I'm saying? So this is for the ones who actually want to utilize information to get them from one spot to their desired reality. In this case, it's creative business, brand development, as an artist, and really overall as a creative, because this can be used throughout all walks of life, all fields, etc., business, etc., no matter what business you're into. So now you've penetrated the market. Now you've understood how to penetrate the market, right? So with those five things, penetrating the market, creating the seal is going to allow you to develop the emotional conviction that you need to actually develop the discipline that you need for yourself to actually go get it done. You need the reasoning behind what and why you're doing, right? What and why you're doing something. Without that, you'll always get knocked off. You'll always be impacted by what other people say online, reviews, critics, things of that nature. When you don't feel motivated, you won't want to put in any work, etc. So these are big things, guys, and these are very crucial. So don't pass these up. You need to develop the reasoning and the emotional conviction that you need so that you understand what you're doing and what you're moving towards here and why you're doing something, right? Well, with that being said, I'm assuming that you guys already want to do music. You guys are already creators, right? I'm speaking to the creators. If this is just something that you want to do, definitely do not do it. This is not something that is a get-rich-quick scheme. This is a real business strategy, right? If you want to get farther in your life as an artist, you do have to learn the business side of things as well. And this is what this is, right? It's important to understand and have a foundation and structure towards your creativity. And it's exactly what we're doing here. So it's important to understand to know what you want to do. And obviously we're in the field of creativity, music, etc., artist development. So I'm assuming you already want to be an artist. Good. Because you shouldn't be doing more of what you don't want to do, period. Any successful individual does not do what they don't want to do repeatedly, right? They do more of what they do want to do, right? Do more of what you want, period. And if it makes you unhappy, don't do it. Delegate it. Let AI do it. Hire someone, right? Etc. Because there's always going to be things we may not like to do. And that's where we hire someone. So we delegate, right? Etc. Save us time from the irritable tasks that we don't want to do. So we spend more time in the tasks that we're actually good at, that push the needle forward, right? So if you do music, everything you do is to push the needle. That's two E's, don't worry about that. Everything you do is to push the needle, right? So that means slowly eliminating everything that you know you need to eliminate over the next however long, right? I'd say create a time span for yourself and get to it, you know, because without goals, you ain't gonna do nothing. Create yourself a time span and understand, clear out everything that you don't want to do. Make a list. What are you doing that frustrates you throughout the day? Eliminate that. Straight up, eliminate it. Do more of what you want to do. If you love music, do more of the music. Learn more of the business side of music. Learn more on how to build a foundation around your music so that you can do music for a very long time, so that you can thrive to do music, so that music can be your career, right? Learn everything you need to allow you to do music full time, so that you're constantly pursuing the bliss state, peace, creating from a place of bliss. And that's the best place that we can create from, because creativity is infinite. But we can't create from that space if we're worried or bombarded from outside world things, right? And things of that nature that are taking our attention, distracting us, allowing us to do things that are getting off our taking us off our path, etc. AKA not doing what we want to do. Anything that pushes us to do the opposite or not to do the thing we want to do is throwing us off our path. So be mindful of that. Of course, things pop up every now and then, and that's okay. So you got to learn how to manage that as the time goes and as you continue to progress. But that's fine. What I'm saying is, relatively in retrospect, is to stay focused on the task at hand and what you're doing, right? Don't get too swayed. Don't procrastinate. And when you notice yourself procrastinating, kick yourself in to get it done, right? This is what you're developing over time. You're obviously, this is going to be tough in the beginning, but it's going to get a lot easier. Things compound on each other. So as you push the needle forward and you continue doing the things that you know help you, and you continue to study music, continue to learn music, and things of that nature, continue to practice your music, you will continue to get better and you continue to see self-improvements. And over time, things will accumulate and things will get easier for you. It's like putting reps in when you go to the gym. You only do a certain amount of squats or a certain amount of curls and you get hit. But once you keep going, there's only a certain amount of time to where, like, you someone who goes to the gym, like myself, versus someone who doesn't go to the gym, I'm doing way more reps, but that's because I'm used to that. My muscles been under more tension, right? Your vocals, your strings have gone through more reps than the next person, right? So the next thing is put the reps in, right? Part three of this, I believe this is part three, but put the reps in, you know? And I apologize if this is a little small for you guys, apologize, but you guys get the point. Put the reps in, right? Because at the end of the day, if you don't put the reps in, you won't develop the muscle needed to get through, to push through. If you do not put the reps in, you will not be ready for when opportunities approach you and when opportunities arrive. If you do not put the reps in, you will not be ready for when opportunities do arrive in your life. Y'all gotta understand that. Y'all gotta understand this. When you put the reps in, you literally building yourself up, and it's important to put the reps in. If you don't put the reps in when you go to the gym, are you gonna be able to do nothing? No. You gotta put the reps in, and you gotta do that every day. Every day, work on your craft. Every day, work. Every day, work. And this is the thing. That's why I tell you, do what you love to do. And if music isn't something you want to do, every single day, to the day that you're dead, don't do it. Because it's not. What if you can't commit to this every day, work, to do something, every day push the needle forward towards what you're doing, then don't do it. You don't love it enough. Because the only reason you see this as work every day, would you go to your 9-to-5 job every day? Would you go to go work at your mechanic job every day? Would you go to go work as a I'm not gonna say salesman, because that's some cool leverage, you know what I'm saying? But would you go work at your construction job every day? You're gonna need some days off, right? You don't love to do that. None of us love to do that stuff. Some of us maybe, and if you love to do it, I'm glad, because we need people like that, and you know, I got a house too, so. Thanks, shout out to y'all. You know what I'm saying? But understand this. If you can't put in the work every day, you don't love it enough. And if you don't love it enough, you're not gonna make it in this. You have to love it to do what you love to do. Because only those who do what you love to do are gonna have the passion, the motivation, and the desire to live this reality. To do this every day. They love it. This is why they do music. To do it every day. Because that's what gives them the fulfillment and the emotional conviction and spiritual wisdom to continue thriving, to reassure their space as a spirit in the world, in a body, on this physical plane, terra firma, right? To understand why they're here, to give them reasoning. This is why those people do music. This is why those people make it, because they live and breathe music. You have to live and breathe music. Music comes first. I don't care what people tell you about marketing, this, that, and the third. Yeah, this is that, and it covers that. But music is the key. Live and breathe music, because that's what's gonna create the love for you to even want to learn the business and want to push your music and want to market and want to post and want to be on social and do all that shit. Want to be on tour and want to go on the road and want to do collabs and want to do all that. You gotta love it. At the end of the day, you gotta love it. It's not the ops, it's not the shots, it's not the gang, it's not the colors, it's not nothing. It's the love for music, it's not the bodies. Sometimes I get it, because that's sometimes where so much of us, where we come from. But at the end of the day, they know, all those same people as well, know exactly why they do music, because it lifts their spirit up. Music brings unity. Of course, sometimes when we bring in unity and we know that's why we can click up and diss each other and stuff like that, because we know it brings unity. And that's why it affects us so much when someone maybe does that to us in music and stuff like that, and tries to diss us and throw shots and things of that nature. Because we understand that it's not just that one person, but maybe a group of people, right? A resonance. And that's an important thing, because that's why the other side will hurt just as much, because they know it's a group of people that are also praising something that they came together for, but it's affecting you, right? But you have to understand, music brings unity, and it'll always bring people together no matter what they're talking about, because that's the power of music. So you have to understand and be the alchemist and be the wizard. If you know music brings people together, it's up to you to alchemize the right words to speak to the souls that you need to speak to allow your music to resonate with the people that they resonate with. Until next time.